And now on to our dinosaur of the day, Vagaceratops, which was a request from PaleoMike716 via our Discord and Patreon, so thanks. Vagaceratops was a chasmosaurine ceratopsian that lived in the Late Cretaceous in what is now Alberta, Canada. It walked on four legs, it had this parrot-like beak, and a large neck frill that curled forward, and a nasal horn.
A neck frill that curled forward?
Like if I curl my fingers a little bit.
Oh, I see.
At the top. Just
gotcha.
The top.
Gotcha. So yeah, I guess that is kind of common in the chasmosaurines, those epiossifications that sort of, they look almost like hair folded over on the top of the frill.
Yeah, a little
like bangs.
Bit. Like, I guess it, yeah, it didn't, the paleo art, it doesn't look like bangs, but I guess you could describe it that way.
Yeah. That's how I think about it. But maybe I'm anthropomorphizing too much.
Maybe. It had really reduced brow horns. So they were more like bosses than horns. And it had a large snout with a broad short horn. Its frill was shorter and more square-shaped compared to the frills of other chasmosaurines. It was wider than it was long.
Hmm.
And it had smaller parietal fenestrae compared to other ceratopsids. So two large holes in the frill that were probably covered by skin. As for the bangs part of the frill, it had 10 epoccipitals, the small bones surrounding the frill, and 8 of them were flattened and curved forward and upward. So if you think about your, I guess, your, if you're curling your fingers inward to your palm, that kind of thing. Vagaceratops was herbivorous. There was a complete maxilla found, that, and they estimated it had about 28 teeth. Alex Tirabasso, an artist for the Canadian Museum of Nature, made 3D models of Vagaceratops to see if ceratopsians walked with their legs sprawled or with their forelimbs like pillars beneath them or somewhere in between. And he found that the in-between posture worked the best. So Vagaceratops and its relatives probably walked with their limbs slightly bent.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, we've heard about that a little bit with ceratopsians and that it seemed like they were actually a little bit sprawled. So that simplification that dinosaurs didn't ever sprawl at all isn't really true, because mm-hmm. we think ceratopsians did, at least with their front legs.
The type species is Vagaceratops irvinensis. It was originally described as a new species of Chasmosaurus as Chasmosaurus irvinensis in 2001, and that was by Robert Holmes, Catherine Forster, Michael Ryan, and Kieran Shepard. And at the time, they named a new species in part because of its broad snout and the low, not really existent brow horns. In place of the brow horns are this pit or rugosities that may show bone resorption, they said, and also the frill with the curling parts of the frill. Then the name changed to Vagaceratops irvinensis in 2010 by Scott Sampson and others, and that genus name means wandering horned face. The genus name Vagaceratops refers to it being a close relative of Chasmosaceratops. And the wandering part is because Chasmosaceratops was found much further away in Utah in the U.S.
Chasmosaceratops, I always think of as having bangs with its curled epiossifications.
So in the 2010 paper by Scott Sampson and others, they found that Chasmosaceratops and Vagaceratops had similar derived frills with the fenestra, the, you know, the holes in the frills, and then the curving forward bones. And they found Chasmosaceratops and Vagaceratops to be sister taxon and not closely related to Chasmosaurus. Vagaceratops, I should also mention, was named in the same paper that named Utahceratops gettyi and Chasmosaceratops richardsoni. And if you want to hear more about those dinosaurs, we talked about Chasmosaceratops in episode 173 and Utahceratops in episode 65. Vagaceratops was found in the Upper Dinosaur Park Formation, so it's much younger than Chasmosaurus belli and Chasmosaurus russelli. The type specimen was found by Luke Lindho near Irvine, Alberta, and then collected by Juan Langston in 1958. It includes most of the skull and the postcranial skeleton in an upright, crouched position. It was found in one block, except for the snout, which fell to pieces before it was discovered and collected separately. The skull was mostly complete but fragmented, and the postcranial skeleton was nearly complete, minus the tail. The skull's made up of several hundred fragments.
Oh, jeez, that must have been fun to put back together.
Yeah. Vagaceratops was thought to be an adult because of a lot of co-ossifications. It was tentatively thought to be Chasmosaurus belli based on the shape of the partially exposed frill, but it actually remained in storage in jackets until the 1980s at the Canadian Museum of Nature.
That often happens if you think it's an existing species.
Mm-hmm. Then Langston and Russell started preparing it in the late 1980s as part of a debate about ceratopsian forelimb posture. And they found, oh, this is a new taxon.
Yeah. There aren't a ton of well-preserved postcranial skeletons of ceratopsians. So that makes sense that they were like, what do we have lying around? You know, where we need limb bones.
Mm-hmm.
They probably didn't have a ton to choose from.
They did find two additional specimens in the same area that were referred to, well, back then, Chasmosaurus irvinensis, but those weren't limb bones. One was a crushed skull and another was a fragmentary skull. It's probably not too surprising. There's a lot of debate around Vagaceratops and whether or not it's a valid genus. Some scientists have said that they think Vagaceratops is an adult form of Chasmosaurus. Others have said that they think it's more closely related to Chasmosaurus, and then others say it was a sister taxon to Chasmosaurus. In 2016, Campbell and others found the frill of Vagaceratops was enough to make it distinct, but they found Chasmosaurus and Vagaceratops to be in a clade together. They did not attribute the other two skull specimens to Vagaceratops, and they said that they showed individual variation within Chasmosaurus belli. In 2019, James Campbell and others looked at Vagaceratops and tentatively reassigned it to Chasmosaurus, and then said, well, more fossils are needed to confirm or refute. They also said, quote, the interrelationships between Chasmosaurus irvinensis, Chasmosaurus belli, and Chasmosaurus russelli remain unclear, end quote. And they said they wouldn't formally assign the two skulls previously referred to Vagaceratops irvinensis to Chasmosaurus irvinensis and reassign them to just Chasmosaurus species.
Hmm.
And in a phylogenetic analysis, it was found that Chasmosaurus and Vagaceratops were in a monophyletic clade.
Which is why they ended up just getting rid of the Vagaceratops, it sounds like.
Not everyone has gotten rid of Vagaceratops. So in a paper from last year, 2020, Denver Fowler and Elizabeth Friedman Fowler, their paper was on transitional evolutionary forms in Chasmosaurine ceratopsid dinosaurs. They referred to Vagaceratops, well, throughout the paper, sometimes they referred to it as Vagaceratops parentheses Chasmosaurus irvinensis, and then sometimes it was Vagaceratops irvinensis. And they hypothesized that Vagaceratops and Chasmosaurus show the most derived and successively youngest members of a Chasmosaurus lineage.
Wow, so this is still hotly contested very mm-hmm. recently.
Yeah, so maybe there'll be more papers in the future about Vagaceratops. For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino or click the link on the left.